As we have studied in compressible fluid flow, that is equations of Bernoulli's equation in isothermal process and adiabatic process, let us apply this equation to solve real life problems. We have a problem over here which states that a gas of velocity 300 meters per second is flowing through an horizontal pipe at a pressure of 6×10⁴ Newton per meter square, which is absolute. So no need to worry. The absolute pressure is given to us. The temperature is 40 degrees Celsius at that point. The pipe changes its diameter, and this section, the pressure is 9×10⁴. So the diameter has changed. Due to the change in the diameter, the pressure has increased. We have to find the velocity of the gas at this section, that is the next section, if it is the flow is taken as adiabatic and universal gas constant and gamma is equals to 1.4. So both the things are given to us. So there is absolutely two things which are mentioned in the problem, that is the inlet as well as the outlet, where the diameter is changing. So we will also differentiate the problem into two parts, that is section 1-1 as well as section 2-2. So let us write down the data accordingly. So the data states that there are two sections, that is section 1 and section 2. So two sections are given to us. So at section 1, the velocity is given to us as V1 is equals to 300 meters per second, and the pressure which is given to you is 6×10⁴, whereas the pressure over here is 9×10⁴ Newton per meter square. This is also Newton per meter square. The temperature T1, which is given to us as 40 degrees Celsius, this comes out to be as equals to 313 Kelvin, that is in Kelvin, that is in absolute Kelvin. Next part which we'll see, which is given to us, are constants, that is R is equals to 287, gamma is equals to 1.4. So these values are given to us. So we have to calculate the value V2, and they have mentioned it is a horizontal pipe. Since it is a horizontal pipe, Z1 is equals to Z2. So we have to calculate V2. For this, we have to apply a Bernoulli's equation, and the process is specified as it is an adiabatic process. It is an adiabatic process. So let us write down Bernoulli's equation for adiabatic process. So this is given by gamma upon gamma minus 1 into P1 upon rho 1 plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 is equals to gamma upon gamma minus 1 P2 by rho 2 into G. Even here this will be G plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2. So this is Bernoulli's equation. So over here Z1 and Z2 will have the same value because it is an horizontal pipe, and here the acceleration due to gravity is same, so it will go away. So we will have the value of Bernoulli's equation as gamma upon gamma minus 1 P1 upon rho 1 plus V1 square by 2 is equals to gamma upon gamma minus 1 P2 upon rho 2 plus V2 square by 2. So we have got the equation. So over here we have a value of P1 and P2, we have value of V1, we have value of this two constant. So we need to calculate V2. For that, the only thing remaining is calculating rho 1 and rho 2. So for this calculation, we can calculate this by applying law of adiabatic process. So for an adiabatic process, we know that P1 upon rho 1 raised to gamma is equals to R into T1. So the value of P1 is 6×10⁴ upon rho 1 raised to gamma is equals to R. R has a value which we can substitute directly, 287, temperature is 313. So, and calculation of this entire part, will get the density of the fluid as equals to rho 1 will be equals to 0.749 kg per meter cube. Note that for calculating this value, you should take the power of this part as equals to 1 upon rho, because you are taking the because this has rho has a value of has a power of rho. So while calculating that, we should take the root of that. Anyways, so we have got value of rho 1. Now, technically speaking, we can calculate rho 2 also, but for that P2 upon rho 2 is equals to gamma is equals to R into T2. Since we do not have the final temperature T2, we cannot use this equation. Then we'll use the second equation for adiabatic process, P1 upon rho 1 raised to gamma is equals to P2 upon rho 2 raised to gamma. So let us substitute the values. This is 6 into 10 raised to 4. This is equals to 9 into 10 raised to 4 upon rho 1 has a value of 0.749 raised to 1 point, which is given as 1.4 is equals to rho 2 raised to 1.4. So and calculation of these and also taking the value of 1 upon 1.4 as the root on the both side, you'll get the value of rho 2 as equals to rho 2 is equals to 1.006 kg per meter cube. Now we can use these two values of rho 1 and rho 2 to substitute in Bernoulli's equation. So let us write down the Bernoulli's equation: gamma upon gamma minus 1 P1 upon rho 1 plus V1 square by 2G is equals to gamma upon gamma minus 1 into P2 upon rho 2 plus V2 square by 2G. Now after calculation of every term, we know P1, V1, rho 1 as well as P2, rho 2. We have to calculate this value. Rest of these terms we are known to us. So let us take all the terms on the other side. So we'll get this as gamma upon gamma minus 1 P1 upon rho 1 minus P2 upon rho 2 inside the bracket plus V1 square by 2G is equals to V2 square by 2G. Note that here we do not have to consider the value of G, since in the equation also there was no value of G, so only this value we have to consider. So now let us substitute. This is 1.4 upon 1.4 minus 1 upon, this is a 6 into 10 to power 4 upon density is 0.749 minus 9 into 10 to power 4 upon density is 1.006 plus V1 square by 2G, V1 square by 2, this is 300 square by 2 is equals to V2 square by 2. The only reason why we have not taken G over here, because the value of G will be in these equations also and all will be cancelled. For the further clarification, we have seen in the previous part we had calculated the values of G on both the sides. This is what is the Bernoulli's equation which we will apply. So now we will calculate the value of this part. On calculation, we get the value of V2 as equals to 113.08 meters per second. So we have calculated the value of V2. So we have calculated the value of V2 as 113.08. Note that while calculating this value, you have to take square root on both the sides. Then only we will get the value of V2 while calculating the part. So we have applied Bernoulli's equation. We have applied also. So we have applied what is Bernoulli's equation in adiabatic process. And also we have applied what is equation of adiabatic process, that is P1 upon rho 1 raised to gamma is equals to R into T1. So by taking all these terms together, we can solve real life problems on Bernoulli's equation and continuity equation in compressible fluid flow. Thank you.